Hi there, my name is Ole and I'm in charge of data and analytics here at Project A. Today we want to talk about data governance. Now this one doesn't really come out on top when asking data people about their favorite thing to do. But then again, not having proper data governance in place might make everything else they're working on useless. So let's start off with some observations we made here at Project A over the years. Generally, we see a steep increase in the sheer number of software tools that a company is using these days, even with our smaller startups using up to 50 tools from the get-go. Now, the data accumulating in these systems can be potentially of high analytical value, yet usually remains pretty siloed and inaccessible. Even once our ventures start investing in proper data infrastructure, they still do struggle with the sheer complexity of data. Now, while this is obviously a data governance problem, most of our ventures are to some extent trapped in another sales pitch for another tool claiming they can finally create clarity over their data. The reality is that we're so caught up in collecting, storing, transforming, analyzing our data that governing usually falls off the table. That is, until some customer data is leaked or the CEO dashboard doesn't refresh anymore. Companies would probably need some sort of data governance, but simply don't know yet where to get started. So let's help them by defining data governance in the most straightforward way. To me, this comes down to a company's ability to consistently handle data throughout the organization. These companies have successfully developed some sort of quality control through the lifecycle of their data from its initial collection until it's eventually being used for a decision or an algorithm. Now, our advice here would be to start small and extend your data governance practice from there over time. So let's talk about how to kickstart data governance at your company. Generally, we would recommend here to follow the well-established PPT framework, and that stands for people, processes, and technology. People, in that sense, relates to the employees that are accountable for data governance. These are sometimes referred to as data stewards and are generally responsible for designing and then also maintaining the previously described quality control along the life cycle of a company's data. These data stewards then also establish certain processes that are needed to ensure proper data governance. These may include best practices in data entry or naming conventions around event tracking or even how to report a certain incident. Now, next to people and processes, you also need technology for proper data governance. And here, tooling falls into three major categories. The first one being data observability. Now, this relates to tooling that helps you to understand that the data coming from different sources hits your central data platform in an expected way, meaning that it's fresh, that the distribution is as expected, and that it adheres to a certain schema. Once the data from various sources is integrated into your central platform, you need data lineage tools to understand how it's being transformed from there. You're probably applying different transformations to make sure business logic is translated into final data sets. And data lineage tools help you to understand and track these transformations over time. Finally, once you create data sets that can be used by end users or algorithms, they need to be also cataloged. And that's what happens through data cataloging tools. These help end users to navigate what's available and how this is being defined. So one exercise in that regard that we usually run through with our ventures is creating what we call a data flow map. Now, a data flow map helps you to map out where data in the business is actually being generated and how it flows from there through different systems, a central data platform, and into reports, analyses, or algorithms. Now, this data flow map easily points out which people are involved, which processes are needed to make sure things are up and running, and also which technology is then again required, coming back to the PPT framework that we described initially. And this one might help you to get started with data governance practice at your company as well. So thank you for joining this little primer on data governance. If there's only one thing that you'd like to take away from this, it would be the following. You can have all the fancy tools in the world for collecting, storing, transforming, or analyzing your data. But as long as you don't govern it properly, you're still pretty much nowhere. So kickstart your data governance practice and make sure data quality exists throughout the entire organization. Thanks for joining and see you soon.